Good morning, guys. Let's continue the same topic, that is subject verb conquered. That means subject verb subject. Okay. In our last one class, we have seen rule number 9. Okay. We have completed rule number 9. Now, today we are going to deal with rule number 10 and the rest. Okay. So here, rule number 10. Rule number 10 is, it is about, there are some names. Okay. There are some names of singular plural nouns. Okay, plural nouns, actually there are many plural nouns which are of country, provinces, or the title of books. Okay, so they carry a singular form of the verb, or singular verb we can say simply. Okay, so here a plural noun which is a name of a country, province, or a title of a book. Okay, so here a plural noun which is the name of a country, province, or the title of a book. So here this plural noun carries singular verb. Okay, carries singular verb. Okay, a plural noun which is the name of किसी चीज का नाम है, विच इज द नेम ऑफ अ कंट्री, प्रोविंसेस मीन्स प्रोविंस, और द टाइटल ऑफ अ बुक, द टाइटल ऑफ अ बुक. सो इन दैट केस द प्लूरल नाउन कैरीज सिंगुलर वर्ब. यस, तो ऐसे केस में वो जो नाउन रहेगा वो सिंगुलर वर्ब कैरी करेगा. ओके, एंड मेनी मोर एग्जाम्पल्स आर देयर. यस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल द फेमस वन बुक. Okay, famous one book, Great Expectations. Okay, Great Expectations. Okay, look at there. It is plural noun, but it is the name of a book. Yes, it is the name of a book. ये किसी एक किताब का नाम है, and that's why it will carry is a famous novel. Is a famous, okay, or well renowned novel. Yes, novel. So here this is the name of a novel. Ek novel ka naam hai, Great Expectations. It is the title of a book. So here, as this one is the title of a book, though it is a plural noun, but it is a title. Okay, एक book का वो नाम है, एक title है, and that's why it carries singular form of the verb. Another example you can say again, that you might have studied in your previous classes. Okay, fairy tales, or the stories from the Arabian Nights. Yes, this is again a name of a book. Yes, the stories from Arabian Nights. So again, that is a name of a book, and that's why it will carry singular form of the verb. So simply you can say the stories from Arabian Nights was prescribed in class 7. So this way was. Yes, though there is stories, though it is plural, but it is a name of book. Yes, and that's why there is was singular form of the verb. Got it? So such, you have to understand what, whether it is the name of any book or country or province, and on the basis of that you have to understand what should be there. Yes? What should be there, like Andaman, Nicobars. Andaman and Nicobars. It is a name of island. Name of island. Okay. So here, it carries again singular form of the verb. So again, another you can say, the United States has a fine navy. Okay. The United States has a fine navy. A fine navy. So look at here. Has. Singular form of the verb is there. Why? Because the United States. United States. It is a name of country. It is a name of country. Ek country ka naam hai. It is a name of country. And that's why it carries with it singular form of the verb. Got it? So name of country, provinces, or any title of book. Though seems plural. Means though the name is plural, plural noun is there, but still they carry with them singular form of the verb or singular verb. They carry singular verb. Got it? So this is rule number 10. Rule number 10. Okay, or if you want to another example, just look at there. The Arabian Nights. Okay, third one example. The Arabian Nights. Okay, look at that again. Nights, the Arabian Nights, plural. Okay, plural noun is there. But what it is, the Arabian Nights, it is a name of book. It is the name of a book. It is the name of a book. Ye ek kitab ka naam hai. It is the name of a book. So, it will carry singular form of the verb. Okay, so what would be there? The Arabian Nights contains many interesting stories. Okay, interesting stories. Arabian Nights, it is again a name of a book. The name of a book. So it carries singular form of the verb. What is that? Contains singular verb. Yes. So this way, when there is a plural noun, which is a name or what can I say, which is the name of a country, which is the name of a country, province, or the title of a book. So they carry singular verb. Yes. So dear, I hope you have understood this rule number 10 very well. Now let's see rule number 11. Okay, so did you understand this rule number 10? Okay, now let's see rule number 11. Okay, rule number 11. What is there? Rule number 11, it is about relative pronouns. Okay, relative pronouns. Understand this, what am I telling you? Relative pronouns. So here, what is this? A relative pronoun. Must. Okay, must agree with the antecedent. Okay, in number and person. Okay, in number and person. So dear, you might not aware what is the meaning of antecedent. Antecedent means the previous one. Okay, uske bilkul pehle aane wala noun, antecedent. Okay, so here the relative pronoun, you might know what are the relative pronouns. okay, in the part of pronoun you might have studied earlier in the previous classes. In the previous classes you might have studied relative pronouns like that, which, who, okay, which, who, whose, means these are the relative pronouns, okay. So these are relative pronouns, okay, relative pronouns agrees, okay, must agree with the antecedent means the previous one, okay, उसके पहले आने वाला antecedent, okay, उस relative pronoun के पहले आने वाला जो antecedent होगा उससे agree करेगा वहाँ का verb, okay. So एक example के तौर पर मैं तुम्हें समझा देता हूँ कि what is relative pronoun and what is antecedent. Okay, antecedent. What is antecedent and what is relative pronoun? Okay, let's see first. एक example देख लेते हैं. Okay, it is I who take, look at there. It is I who am to blame. Okay, so look at there in this sentence. In this sentence, first of all, understand what is relative pronoun here. Here, relative pronoun is who. This is relative pronoun. Okay, relative pronoun. As I told you, who, yes, that, which, these are called relative pronouns. Okay, or go through your copies of previous classes. There you will find what is relative pronoun. Okay. So here this who is called relative pronoun, okay, and then what is antecedent? So here antecedent to relative pronoun is this is antecedent, okay. I is antecedent here in this sentence. Yes, sentence mein antecedent kaun sa hai? I. Got it? So here antecedent of the relative pronoun. This relative pronoun ka antecedent hai I. Yes? Look at there again another example to make it clear. Okay, isko clear karne ke liye aur ek example dekh lete hain. It is he or another example look at there. It is you who are to blame. It is you who are to blame. Okay, so look at here, relative pronoun who. Relative pronoun is here who, and you is antecedent, and who is relative pronoun. Okay, and you is here antecedent. So in this case or in this part, you can say that here the verb that is this antecedent, sorry, relative pronoun agrees to antecedent. So here because of I there is am, because of you there is are. Yes, so here in this case verb agrees to the antecedent of the relative pronoun के पहले आने वाले उस verb को, sorry, उस noun को या फिर pronoun को verb agree करता है. Okay, but here I just want to tell you what is antecedent and what is relative pronoun. I hope this idea is clear. Now we will see the examples. Okay, so do write and understand what is relative pronoun and what is antecedent. Okay. So then let's see examples. Okay, so example, this is the cow, okay, which gives milk. Okay, this is the cow which gives milk. So look at here. Which is here? Relative pronoun. Yes, relative pronoun. Got it? Antecedent.
cow. Antecedent, what is here? Cow. Cow is antecedent here, and which is relative pronoun.
So now look at there. A relative pronoun must agree with the antecedent in number and person. In number and person. So here what is there? Cow. Cow. In singular number. And that's why there is singular verb. Gives. Gives. Singular verb. Okay. Look at there. Singular. Singular verb. Gives. Same example, let's see same example, okay, with some changes. Same example with some changes. Look at there. These, okay, instead of these are the cows. These are the cows which give milk. Which give milk. Look at there. Same sentence with some changes. Same sentence with some changes. So look at here. These are. Why? Because it is cows. Cows. Cows is there. Cows is there. Plural. Okay. So here cows is plural. Plural. And that's why here plural form of the verb give. Plural verb. Plural verb give is there. So here this relative pronoun. Relative pronoun agrees to the antecedent. And on the basis of that, verb form is used. On basis of that, verb form is used. Okay, either singular verb or plural verb. Depends on this antecedent. Depends on this antecedent. Got it? Whether it is miss, we have to decide what number it is in, singular or plural. Then person. Yes, first person pronoun, second person pronoun, or third person pronoun. Yes, on basis of that, we have to use verb form. Okay, got it? So this is rule number 11. Rule number 11. Okay, or let's see again another example of this type. Okay, so I am going to rub it. Okay, do write in your copy fast. Why? Because I am going to rub it. Okay, so now let's see again another example. Okay, another example. One, two, three. Okay. It is the book. It is the book that was gifted to me. That was gifted to me. So look at here. That was gifted to me. Here was is there. Why? Because here this relative pronoun. Okay. Relative pronoun. And this book. Book is antecedent. Antecedent. Okay. यह वही किताब है जो मुझे गिफ्ट की गई थी. गिफ्ट की गई थी. Okay. So here it is the book that was gifted to me. That was gifted to me. Okay. So here, as this is in singular number, was is there. Was is there. Singular form of the verb. If there were books, so then there would be were. But here again, some changes would be there. Okay. So here, you must understand that this relative pronoun agrees to the antecedent. Agrees to the antecedent in person and number. Got it? I hope you got this rule very well. Now see rule number 12. Rule number 12. Okay. Now let's see rule number 12. What is rule number 12? Okay. It is about there. Okay. Rule number 12. Rule number 12. So what is that? When there is there as the subject, so the verb agrees to the number of nouns. Yes, number of nouns. So now look at there, rule number 12. When a sentence begins with there,
Okay, understand this. There, T-H-E-R-E. When a sentence begins with there. Okay. So, in this case, the verb. Verb agrees to the number. To the number of the real subject. Number of the real subject. Real subject or what we can say? Noun. Okay. Noun. So here, when a sentence begins with there, the verb agrees to the number of the subject. Subject means here, real subject. Okay. It is better to write down here, number of the real subject. Okay. Real subject or noun. Okay, real subject or noun. So here you have to understand what is real subject. In the case when there is there as the main subject, means as subject, or a sentence begins with there. In this case there is two subject, means there are two subjects there. Okay, and another would be their real subject. So, in this case, verb agrees to the number of real subject or noun, okay, which is there in the sentence. By example, you can easily understand that. Look at there. There are some boys. There are some boys. So, look at there. There. When sentence begins with there, the verb agrees to the number of noun. The number of noun that is real subject. Abhi sentence mein real subject hai. Boys. So boys, it is in plural number. And that's why there is are. Yes, same example. Let's see same example. Okay. There is a boy. So here, a boy is there. The real subject. And that's why there is. Is is there. So this is what I want to tell you here. When a sentence begins with there, so in this case, the verb agrees to the real subject or what you can say, the following noun, the number of the following noun. Okay, so this is very one example, very easy rule. Okay, that actually you are already aware with. Okay, jiske sath tum already aware ho. So, but just write in your copy. Now let's see another one example. Oh, sorry, another one rule. Okay, another one rule. Rule number 13. Okay, rule number 13, it is about collective nouns. Okay, pay attention. Okay, what I am going to tell you here, collective nouns. Okay, very important this one. Okay, generally means a collective noun generally takes singular verb. Okay, a collective noun Generally takes a singular verb. Okay, generally takes a singular verb. Okay, but in some cases means when it was intended to express each member of that group. Yes, in that case. Okay, so here what I want to tell you here that a collective noun generally takes a singular verb, but when it stands for a collection as a whole. Okay, as a whole. Are you getting here? When a collective noun stands for a collection as a whole, it carries singular verb. And एंड वेन वेन दैट कलेक्टिव नाउन व्हाट कैन से स्टैंड्स फॉर ऑल द मेंबर्स ओके सारे मेंबर्स के लिए अगर वो स्टैंड हो रहा है सो इन दैट केस इट कैरीज प्लूरल फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब यस ओके सो लुक एट देयर एंड व्हेन व्हेन अ प्लूरल वर्ब ओके और व्हाट कैन से अ प्लूरल वर्ब अ प्लूरल वर्ब व्हेन व्हेन इट स्टैंड्स फॉर व्हेन इट स्टैंड्स फॉर ओके व्हेन इट स्टैंड्स फॉर द इंडिविजुअल्स स्टैंड्स फॉर द इंडिविजुअल्स इंडिविजुअल्स ऑफ ऑफ द ग्रुप ऑफ द ग्रुप ओके और इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द ग्रुप दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ओके जिस चीज से बनाए उसके इंडिविजुअल्स को अगर वो रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है ओके सो इंडिविजुअल्स ऑफ द ग्रुप इट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ ओके कंपोज्ड ऑफ और जिससे वो बना हुआ है सो इन दिस केस लुक एट द कलेक्टिव नाउन जनरली टेक्स अ सिंगुलर वर्ब व्हेन इट स्टैंड्स फॉर अ कलेक्शन एज अ होल एंड अ प्लूरल वर्ब And a plural verb when it stands for the individuals of the group of which it is made of. Of which it is made of. Individuals of the group of which it is made of. Okay. जिस चीज का वो बना हुआ है उस ग्रुप के अगर इंडिविजुअल्स को अगर रेफर कर रहा है स्टैंड मतलब वहां बात हो रही उनकी सो इन दैट केस इट कैरीज प्लूरल फॉर्म अदरवाइज व्हेन इट स्टैंड्स फॉर द होल यस सो इट कैरीज सिंगुलर वर्ब जनरली ओके जनरली वो कैरी सिंगुलर ही करता है ओके लेट्स सी एग्जांपल्स जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड हियर व्हाट ओके स्टैंड्स फॉर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर स्टैंड्स फॉर अ कलेक्शन And here stands for individuals, individuals of the group. Okay, उस group के individuals के लिए अगर stand हो रहा है so plural, collection के लिए stand हो रहा है so singular. Okay, do right, then let's see examples, some examples of this type. Done? Okay. So now, let's see here, some examples are there of this rule. Okay, rule number 13. The whole class is absent here. Just look at there, here class. Class, it is a collective noun. Class, mob, jury, crew. Okay, police, cattle. Okay, so here, these such words are called collective nouns. Okay, collective nouns. So here, The collective nouns, as we have seen, when it stands for the collection, whole collection, yes, collection as a whole. So in that case, it carries singular verb. Yes. So look at that. The whole class is absent. So here, this whole class is standing for the collection. As a whole, yes, and that's why there is. Look at there again another the mob, collective noun again has dispersed. How could you understand? So here mob actually here denotes the whole the collection of the all people collection of all people as a whole. Yes, जो पूरे सारे लोग वहाँ गैदर थे, they all disperse. So here the word mob, the collective word mob is standing for the whole collection. Okay. So here has is there. Another thing, look at there. The jury has four members. Okay. So here jury again has been taken as a collection और jury का जो पूरा collection है it is taken as a whole okay उसमें चार members होते हैं but here look at the next example the jury have different opinions different opinions. So here this word, these words, different opinions clears that here the word jury stands for the individuals of the noun of which it is made of. क्योंकि हाँ different opinions जब बोला है मतलब हर एक व्यक्ति उस jury का उनका अलग अलग विचार है. मतलब यहाँ it is talking about each member of that jury. Yes, हर एक member की यहाँ बात हो रही है, individuals की बात हो रही है, and that's why there is have. Okay, same they are located there in the another example. The crew were arrested means each and every member of that crew were arrested. Means each and every member of that crew was arrested. Each and every. हर एक member. Yes, it is talking about individuals. उस crew के सारे members की बात हो रही है के सारे arrested हो गए. Yes, it is talking about individuals. And that's why there is were. Why? Look at the another sentence. The crew has sailed off. Means that group as a collection, chale gaya, sail off ho gaya. Yes? So here, crew, here as a collection, here, individuals, collection. And that's why the verb form is different. Okay? So you have to understand the meaning of or what intention is there behind the collective noun. Yes, that is used. जो भी collective noun वहाँ use हुआ है उसका intention तुम्हें समझना चाहिए and on the basis of that you have to use either singular verb or plural verb. Okay, got it? So this is rule number 13. Okay, now we will see the last one rule, rule number 14. Okay, then subject verb topic completed, subject verb conquered. Okay, so now let's see rule number 14. So now look at there, rule number 14. When two subjects are joined by not only but also. When two subjects are joined by not only but also, in this case, the verb agrees to the nearest subject. That means latter subject. Nearest subject, or you can write there latter. Okay, latter subject. Okay, so when two subjects are joined by not only but also, the verb agrees to the latter subject. Okay, or nearest subject we can say. For example, look at the example. Okay, let's see examples. Huh? So now let's see examples. First one is not only he, but also his companions. Okay, not only. Okay, where two subjects are joined here. He and all his companions. Joined by not only but. Okay, not only or what can say not only but also. Here sometimes we do not write also, but here it is understood. Okay, so not only he, but all his companions were arrested. So look at there, latter subject is in plural number, and that's why there is plural verb. Okay, why? Because there is plural subject means plural number, means the subject is in plural number, and that's why there is plural subject. Okay, latter subject here, this is latter subject. Okay, and this one is first subject. Okay, first subject and latter subject. So here, as this one is first subject and latter subject, so here the rule is when two subjects are joined by not only but also, the verb agrees to the latter subject or nearest subject, and that means here companions. So it is plural, and that's why were is there. Same here, not only you but also I is there, the nearest subject, and that's why there is am. Yes, why? Because there is I. So this is what I want to tell you here. When two subjects are joined by not only but also, the verb agrees to the nearest subject or the latter subject. Got it? So here all the rules of subject verb conquered here completed. Okay, so go through all the rules again and do understand this topic, subject verb agreement, very well. Okay, so in our next one video lecture, we will see some other topic. Okay, so guys, bye bye. See you soon. Keep watching the videos and enjoy the classes. Bye bye.